get that. We're going to have to figure out how to get back our government. You can talk about the travesty all you want. You can talk about the money that the Koch brothers put in the 2012 election. They put in more money than the McCain campaign did. This is how billionaires and millionaires are influencing our democracy. And look at the money that the big fossil fuel polluters put in the last election. Just in the last 2 months, they put $270 billion flooding our democracy again and drowning out the people. They are buying themselves access to our government. They go in the front door with their huge dollars and they leave us up in the nosebleed section if we can even get in. This is not the way our democracy is supposed to be working. But I don't want to talk about the travesty. I want to talk about what we do to get back our government. And so we've got to start in places like this. There's rallies all across the country today that people are learning about this particular event. They need to then take their steps to take back their government. So there are many initiatives we can do in the Congress through Roots to Amend, here in the state of California with the Disclosure Act. There are people here that can tell you about any of these things.
This is the death of democracy. The idea that there could be no limits on campaign contributions is not a level playing field. So how can we compete with our $25 contributions? And it's estimated now that 40 American families can do more than all of us. So really the wealth, the plutocracy, the oligarchy is calling the shots. We need to amend the Constitution and we need to come out. And I thank you very much for doing that today, because there have been many amazing movements in this country, from women's rights to civil rights to stopping wars to doing all kinds of things. And we can do it again, and we must do it again. And I'm doing it for my daughter and her future and for the next generation. And I know you're here for the same. Coming out in the middle of the day just saying, okay, you got an email and you're going to wind up at City Hall at 5 o'clock. You're all very special people, so thank you for coming. Lindsay, are you here?
I'm here.
You want to say, where is Lindsay?
I'm right here.
Come on in, Lindsay.
My name is Lindsay Van Dyke. I am a digital media strategist with Free Speech for People. It's a national nonprofit organization. And related rulings. And so it's great to be here today and to see some new people show up. And I hope that we'll be able to do it.
A Supreme Court ruling from Minor v. Hutchinson said that essentially women didn't have the right to vote. As now, as we all know, 45 years later or so, that ruling was overturned, and that then became the 19th Amendment. And what we're looking at right now, I believe, is another tipping point in history where the lopsidedness of power and a lopsidedness of injustice and ability for people to take a stand is no longer, people are becoming aware of it, and it's only a matter of time before we can come together and overturn either Citizens United, which will then in turn, with an amendment, will then in turn also overrule the budget. I also just wanted to say that the issue with money and politics, you know, and particularly people criticize and say that this is a free speech, an issue about free speech, and
exactly.
And so what I have to say to that is the McCutcheon ruling is as much about free speech as Supreme Court ruling in 1875 was about women being unfit to vote. It's really about controlling the power of agency and repressing certain citizens in society, which at that point was women and now is everybody except the people that are calling the shots. And so this issue is incredibly important because it affects every other social and environmental and labor issue. Trace anything back, it always goes back to money and politics. And so my personal hope is that different groups coming from the environmental standpoint, ableism from any standpoint to join together so we can try to fix this issue together. Truly, some of the other issues will then hopefully work out as well. So, like I said, I just wanted to thank you all again for coming. Hopefully, with continued support and continued actions like such as this, we'll see the 28th Amendment to the Constitution within our lifetime, within the next 10 years or even less. So, thank you so much.
Yeah.
Hi, can everyone hear me this time?
Yeah.
Okay, tremendous. We've had two terrible decisions by the Supreme Court, Citizens United, and today McCutcheon. They've opened the floodgates to unlimited spending by billionaires and corporations. The California Clean Money Campaign has already been working throughout the state to end the dominance of big money in California politics. We've been around for 12 years, and we have a strategy to turn this thing around. And there are three steps. One is disclose, two is clean money public financing, and three is amend the U.S. Constitution. Now, amending the U.S. Constitution comes last because it's going to take the longest. I'm in it for the long term. I hope you are too.
Yes.
Clean money public financing has been on the ballot twice. It has failed to get a majority of the voters in California. The one thing that we need to do to turn that around is to pass the Disclose Act. And by the way, the Disclose Act is the fastest thing we can do to turn around the power of big money because we can pass it this year. It has already passed the state Senate last year by a two-thirds majority. It's now in the state assembly. And this is the best year to pass it. It will pass by, you know, hopefully by the end of the summer. It will go to Governor Brown's desk and it could be in effect either for the next election or the election after that. But it's going to change how the outcome of elections in California. Because once people find out in every election ad who's spending the big money to influence their votes, that big money is going to backfire on a lot of those big spenders. And they're going to find out that even though they're oil companies with unlimited money to spend, that does not guarantee them the victory in election campaigns anymore. And so that's the first step, and that's why I need everyone here to sign the Disclose Act petition to the legislature and help us get it passed. We've got volunteer groups all over the state, but we need lots of people to write letters, make phone calls, and do all the things that volunteers do to pass a bill in the legislature. As you all know, nothing happens in the legislature unless people make it happen. People outside the legislature make it happen. And we can do it. It's SB 52, the California Disclose Act. Please sign the petition and give it back to me. Thank you very much.
Right. Hey, hey, ho, ho, McCutcheon has got to go.
Hey, 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 ho, ho, McCutcheon has got to go.
Hey, hey, ho, ho, McCutcheon has got to go. Hey, hey, ho, ho, McCutcheon has got to go.
Hey,
ho, ho, corruption has got to go. Hey, hey,
ho, ho, corruption has got to go. Hey, hey,
ho, ho,
corruption has got to go. Hey, hey,
ho, ho,
corruption
has got to go. Hey, hey,
ho, ho,
big money has got to go. Hey, hey,
ho, ho,
thank you for coming out here. Do we have any other speakers? Anybody want to make a stand here? How about UC Berkeley coming on up here? Student activist graduate, Lauren.
Yeah.
Well, you're graduating student activist right here, right here from the training.
I say it's wonderful to see so many people out here and to see that so many people are still caring what happens here. This rally is a beautiful thing, but the problem with situations like this is sometimes we don't know what to do next. And we need something to do. And we're starting it tomorrow at UC Berkeley. Dan Newman and Matt Black started a campaign to get public funding of elections in Berkeley. And that will be one of the first cities to do so. And it's becoming more and more clear that we're not going to be able to do this at the federal level. We must start at the local level and build it up state by state. So we're starting that tomorrow by trying to get more students involved. And after we get more students involved, we're going to get more people like yourself involved. Now we get more people like yourself involved, we're going to get city council involved. If we get city council involved, we're going to get state legislature involved. And then we're going to overturn Citizens United and McCutcheon.
All right.
Yeah.
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 and then we'll take a break. So if anybody might get interested, a few things. One, we are trying to all these pictures and beautiful videos that people are taking. I don't know if you saw, but some of these events were on New York Times, and we need to get this out. So if you have any video, please send it to me, or I can tell you where to send it for the Money Out and Flutters and website. We can also use your help if you're interested tomorrow. UC Berkeley Sprout Plaza, 11 to 2. We'll be trying to get students involved, sign up, sign our petition, and get this campaign started. I hope to see you there. If you have any questions, feel free to contact me. And I'd also like to collect any of your signs if you not use them, so we can use them tomorrow.
Yay!
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
If you can tweet any of this to @BillMoyers. I got word that Bill Moyers is collecting footage and any kind of pictures and everything, because he's going to do an expose on all the demonstrations that are happening across the country. They started this morning at the Supreme Court. They've been rolling across the country. All this stuff is being collected. How do movements start? Yes, one person. One person tells one person, and then we get crowds like this. And over time, it's going to take a while, but we will have the majority of the crowds, because there is no democracy if only wealthy people call the shots. Can I have anybody else up here who want to say a few words?
UC website.
Oh, what? Yes, one more thing. We cannot let that go. Here.
Sorry about that. I'm not sure. We have a few websites going right now, but I can try the Money Out Voters and website. Show the contact information on that. Or you can email. It's Money Out Voters In. If you just Google that, I'm sure you'll find it. Or you can feel free to get my contact information. I'm leading the UC Berkeley Root Strikers, and we're going to be collecting all of it and sending it to where it needs to go once we find that out as well. Just find me after, and I'll be happy to help. And also, please come out tomorrow, 11 to 2, Sproul Plaza. I'll see you there.
And we have 350.org, and we have also Move to Amend. So who's going to come and say something for them? Go ahead.
I'm with another group. My name is David Turnbull. I'm with Oil Change International, which is also a partner in Money Out Voters In. We've been tracking fossil fuel money in politics for years now, and there's some things that I want to say about Sean McCutcheon in particular, in case you didn't know. Sean McCutcheon is a coal baron. He doesn't believe in climate change, and he's in the pocket of Mitch McConnell. This is a man who has been pushing for influence in politics so he can continue his ways of destroying our planet, destroying our climate, and destroying our communities with his coal industry and with fossil fuels in general. McCutcheon versus FEC is about the influence of these types of corporations in politics. It's about the fact that our voices as people are not being heard, and it's seen every day in Congress. We track the amount of campaign contributions to Congress, and what we've seen is that fossil fuels, the industry, gives millions of dollars every year to Congress, and in return they get billions of dollars every year in subsidies. That's a 5,800% return on investment, if you think about it that way. It's an investment that, of course, they're smart to take, but it's an investment that is ruining our planet, and it's ruining our democracy. So we track this influence at dirtyenergymoney.com, and we hope that you can go there. You can see how much money every single representative in Congress has from fossil fuels. And we're also tracking it at the state level, too. We're running a campaign against fracking in California. We've seen that Jerry Brown is getting a ton of money from the fossil fuel industry as well. We've brought in big oil Brown because he's allowed fracking to continue in the state at the behest of the oil industry. So we hope you'll visit bigoilbrown.org as well. But the last thing I want to say is this. The industry has more money than we can ever imagine and more money than we can ever put into politics. But the thing is, we can vote. The industry can't. We have the voices. The industry doesn't. And we're on the right side of history. So when it comes down to it, this is a setback to be sure. But with our voices and by raising our voices, we can come back from this, and we're going to take back our democracy.
All right.
Something for those organizations. Anyone else come up here?
Yes, sir.
Oh, no. This is really what free speech is about. It's not about money.
My name is Andy, and I'm with Occupy San Francisco.
Yay!
Yeah. And I just want to toss it out there that campaign finance is one issue, but the bottom line is that we have an economic system that has resulted in incredible economic disparity. I think that is the core problem, and that's the one that we really need to address. I think it is very simple and straightforward. We need a different economic system. Berkeley filmmaker Donald Schumacher, Goldmacher, and that pretty explains why things have become so inequitable over the last 30 years. So, let's fight for campaign finance reform, but let's also try a bigger picture of economic inequality, and let's try to create an economic system that works for everybody.
Hi, my name's Art Furstichel with SF99, that coalition, the banner's right there. We cover a multiplicity of issues. Everything leads back to corporate power and money. It's uniting the 99%. We can see where the problem is. So, at every level, whether it's city, state, or federal, we have things to do. We're doing it here locally right now. There's, we're seeing a scandal in the California legislature right now. It's not just Leland Yee. You know, it's a system that allows pay for play, whether it's directly or indirectly done. There's far too much power and influence in the money and corporations. At the federal level, Bernie Sanders has some legislation that would be address this as well. So check out Bernie Sanders' website. But thank you all for coming here, and we got to just keep going.
Absolutely, got to keep going.
Yeah.
Like I said, this is free speech. No money involved.
Hi, everyone. My name is Kurt Reese, and I'm with 99 Drive. We are a grassroots organization to get big money out of politics via a mass movement of direct nonviolent resistance. I mean, direct nonviolent action, escalating action. I'm really encouraged and heartened to see you all out here to get out here in such short notice. It's my heart that people will come out and do what needs to be done. And that's what we kind of have to raise the bar to at this point. Co-founder Kai Newkirk interrupted the Supreme Court a couple of weeks ago in an unprecedented where he said, I arise on behalf of the American people who say that money is not speech, corporations are not people, keep the cap on McCutcheon. That did not happen as we see today. But it's going to take active civil disobedience and an incredible organization of the 99% to actually reverse this. And just like Andy said, from Occupy, the problem is an incredible discrepancy between the 99% and the 1%. But now the 1% is using that discrepancy to protect and promote that imbalance even more via their influence on the legislature. So unless we can get money out of politics and replace it with citizen-funded elections, we are not going to make meaningful reform or change in any of these key fights. So, I'm going to pass out some flyers. We've got a training coming up in a month, the start of May. We would really love it if you guys could get involved in this movement and fight to take back our democracy to 99%. We're doing a big march from L.A. to Sacramento this summer. You guys are going to hear about it, but keep it going down now. Thank you so much for coming out. Can't wait to work with you.
People who run this world, and there's 7 million of us, so we aren't the 99%, we're a million to one, and we need to let them know that we're not going to tolerate them running our life. We need to impeach the Supreme Court, the Bush Supreme Court, especially Uncle Tom.
All right, everybody, hey, hey, ho, ho, McCutcheon has got to go, hey, hey, ho, ho. McCutcheon has got to go. Hey, hey, got there. Ho, ho. McCutcheon has got to go. Hey, hey. Ho, ho. McCutcheon has got to go. Hey, hey. Ho, ho. McCutcheon has got to go. Hey, hey. Thank you very much. I'm Helen Greco from California Common Cause. Wonderful organization, 40-some-odd years old, absolutely dedicated to getting money out of politics. That's what I'm going to be spending the next 10 years of my life doing, is passing the baton to the next generation. I hope you talk to your family members and your friends and your coworkers. No movement was ever built without that kind of grassroots action. And how many of you have been in other movements before? Women's rights, civil rights, ending the war. Yes, yes, yes. Green movement, sustainable movement, you name it. So we are it. We are democracy. We are the live workings of democracy. Nobody involved. Okay, thank you very much for coming out.
look for emails from all our organizations. We work together in coalition to do the right thing. You are the right thing. Democracy is the right thing. These decisions have to be taken down. Thank you so much for your commitment to being a civic citizen that does the right thing.
Thank you.
Good night, everybody.